basically a year and a half that I was dead drunk all the time. So you've got a drunk guitar player working in a stained glass door cutting glass. It was bad all around. Bad idea. But it all worked out. And at that time, I didn't write any songs. I would kind of mess around in my little room in the sprawling Victorian house that I found an attic room in, and in Berkeley near Solano Avenue. And there was a skylight in the roof of the room, and I used to crawl out from that attic room onto the roof with a six-pack of something and look out across the bay at the lights of the city and kind of ponder my fate. And I would jot things down, but I never thought much about it. Little song ideas and lyric ideas down, but I never thought much about it. And in late 1979, or actually a little later than that, a guy named Buddy Miller, who I hope you've heard of. Buddy and Julie Miller. If you haven't, check Buddy Miller out and his wife Julie Miller. Asked me to come to New York City and join his country band, because this was 1980 and Urban Cowboy had just blown up. So everybody wanted to ride mechanical bulls and do line dancing in New York and a lot of other places. So he went to New York to show him how it's done. And I joined the band and got to New York, where I spent 13 years, and everything cool happened to me in New York City. So this song starts in the attic room, basically, at the stained glass door, and takes you right to New York City with me. And this is the song that I started in that attic room. And didn't think it was anything. And then once I got to New York and started getting my shit together, years and years later, I went, maybe there was something to this song.